grateful and we commend you all for such a feat. The same trust and confidence you reposed in us when it came to all the activities of the EC, there were few instances of issues. Most of them were dealt with by arresting the people involved. A few of them are still on the run, and there's a price tag on them. And we'll tell them we'll keep looking for them. And we know that some of them will attempt to show up during the elections. We'll be waiting for them. So if you really want to vote, then submit yourself to the police. We'll deal with you in accordance with the law, because even now prisoners even can vote. Other than that, you continue to be on the run, the election will be over. Because wherever we find you, we'll be there with you. And that is the message. So that one too, we thank you so much for working together and bringing us that far when it came to all the registration, transfer of vote, exhibition of the voter register, and everything. With a pocket of incidents, on the whole, it was excellent. And we commend you also for that. Another commendation, which goes to your leadership, especially the presidential candidates and all the officials crisscrossing the country, how far you've conducted yourselves in the whole campaigning process, that we have about 2 weeks, 15 days or thereabout, into the elections. And so far, with a few pocket of incidents, we haven't heard anything that is beyond the control in terms of maintenance of law and order. And at times, people are even saying, foreigners who came to Ghana are finding out whether truly we are having election in this country, compared to even the tension in other environment, including the well-established democracies in their recent elections, which the tension is nowhere near what we are experiencing as a people. And if there are people to be commended, it's you. And we can say it's a new dawn of politics in Ghana, and we are proud of you as politicians, and we are proud of you as Ghanaians, and we thank you, and we pray that the rest of the period for the campaigning, you bear with us for us to walk through this successfully and be able to show to the world that indeed the black man is capable of managing his own affairs. I've also want to make one point clear, and that's our commitment towards ensuring that there is peace, security, law, and order in this country. We've said it with the mantra, where we need to engage, we will engage. Where we need to de-escalate, we will de-escalate. But where we need to be merciless when it comes to the application of law within the context of rule of law, under our democratic dispensation, we can tell you that for the sake of the sanctity of the state called Ghana, which our forebears left it in peace for us to leave it in peace for our generation following us, probably and possibly and obviously our children, we'll stop at nothing. And I repeat, we'll stop at nothing to get it done to the glory of God and for the benefit of the generation that will come after us. So we want to assure you that. We equally want to assure you, with all the concerns coming, we'll enter into that discussion when the press is out. But we equally want to assure you that we are committed and we'll continue in this regard to put Ghana first, to put the Ghanaian first, to put the African first, and to prove the black man first, and not to take sides in anything. Because at the end of the day, if we do that and something happens, it will affect all of us. And more importantly, it will affect our children that we love so much. And we are not, collectively we say, going to allow that. The next point I want to make on behalf of my colleagues is the fact that we as politicians have to be realistic. Realistic in the sense that, looking at the presidential ballot, there are 12 presidential candidates on it. 13. According to the EC, as at this morning, there are 12. So we will do that reconciliation. But the 12 presidential candidates on it, or the 13, depending on where you got your information from, and hopefully this is not misinformation, disinformation, because I knew I was going to speak, so I spoke to the EC's office this morning, and they sent me a test to that effect, that with the 13 or the 12, whichever it is, there is one thing that is clear. Only one and only one will win. The rest will not win. In the same way, the 801 and that one too from EC, I don't know whether that was also differ from that of the political parties. At least for this one, you're on the same page. So I quoted my source. As an academic, I have to give you my source so that you don't hold me responsible for the figures. So the 801 vying for a position of 276, only, and I mean only 276, will win. The rest will not win. We need to come to this realization and therefore measure our expectations. So if I want to be very blunt, I will say that as you plan to celebrate your victory, your possible victory, plan also to celebrate your possible defeat or endure the defeat. So that at the end of the day, Ghana and Ghanaians will be the only winner in this election, as it has been said. And the beauty of it is this. Ghana has always been a trailblazer when it comes to anything Africa and beyond. And the world is looking up to us. So when we do that by being very circumspect with our expectations, knowing that only one will win, and knowing that only 276 will win and the rest will fall by the roadside, and as long as the systems and everybody plays their role and ensuring that there is fairness, there is transparency, and everybody is comfortable, when Ghana finally win in this call or in this regard, and the Ghanaians also win in this regard, it is a win for the black man, and it's a win for the African. Because at the end of it all, people always think that we cannot get it right. Let's prove them wrong. And as some of our colleagues said, you think you have friends, wait until you are in a situation that you need help badly. It's then that you will see that you are alone. Let us protect what we have. And when we do that, we'll be doing a great service to ourselves and to our children and those that will come after us. And in doing that and in this discourse, it is on that note that we continue to reassure you of our commitment to ensure that we play our role fairly, professionally, firmly, and also within the rule of law. And when we do that, all what we also expect from you, and also from all the other stakeholders, is also for them to play their role in a way that, as it was said, when the different parts come together, the beauty of it goes beyond anybody's imagination. So as we look forward to engaging you and letting you tell us what the issues are, we want to once again remind you that we are ready for the elections and we have put in place sufficient plans, and we need your support and cooperation to ensure that the plan is fully operationalized to the benefit of all of us, and for us to come out of this election as winners together for the sake of Ghana and for the sake of the black man. I thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Inspector General of Police, Dr. George Akuffo Dampare. Our esteemed security chiefs, distinguished invited guests, ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the end of the first part of this program. May I kindly request the media to excuse us so that we can get into the second session.